callers tonight who are viewing us from coast to coast in the United States on ESPN. Underway at the Coliseum, game two of the 85-86 series. The Edmonton Oilers tonight against Central Red Army. Picked up by Suminen. Now it goes to the Soviets once more, who start back led by Gerasimov. Good drop pass. Good save by Andy Moog from Kenyatown, number 15. Moog had to be sharp on that one. Another chance for the Soviets. Moving in, Gerasimov. Off a leg, out in front. Another save by Moog and batted away. Back to the line. And the Soviets keep it in. This is Kasatanov, number 6. Oilers were lucky to come out of that one. Moog had to make a couple of big saves. This is Huddy. Riding out Kasatanov, number 6 for Central Red Army. For the Oilers now. Sherman, 28 along the boards. It comes back to him. Look for an open wing. No one there. Semenko after it. So is Drozdetsky, number 13. Nice pass in the center ice area. Shepelev, 27. Good pass going in. Moog, brilliant save. And on the rebound, they score. Moog made the initial save. And on the rebound, the Soviets have taken the lead.
What a great, great pass. Right, watch this pass here. Puts the player home free. He just walks around the outside, and Moog comes out with a stick check, but didn't have a chance in the world to get back up to control the rebound or make a save on the rebound. The Soviets came close to scoring on two occasions before that, and Moog made unbelievable saves.
Jackson to the line, and across for Edmonton. In behind the Soviet goal. McClellan is out in front. Randy Gregg moving in, can't get a shot away. Gregg flips it into the corner, still controlling it for Edmonton. Starikov for the Soviets, working against McClellan. Moving in, Suminen, number 25 for Edmonton. Now the Soviets, Bykov. Gerasimov starts the Soviets out, taking a return pass now. Suminen for the Oilers to the line of the cross. Dropped it for McSorley. McSorley going in, takes that, scores! Marty McSorley.
Well, it was a great drop pass that held the Soviet defense right there. Watch this. You have two Soviet defensemen, particularly that left guy, chasing him as he cut across in front. And the drop pass was misplayed first by McSorley. But boy, he just kicked it off his skate. Look at there, right up on his stick. And then he picked the far corner.
Now Kasatanov, number 6, plays it over to the right side. Gerasimov, number 12, back for Fedosov. The shot deflected out in front, and they score between Moog's legs. The shot from the point deflected out in front.
Watch Fedosov here as he winds up. He slides it along the ice. Moog is out where he should be, and there's a Soviet player comes in and just lays his stick on the puck that was shot purposely along the ice. Look at this. The back of his stick hit the ice first in order to keep it down.
Back for Lowe. Man on the right side, Suminen. He's ridden out by Babinov. McClellan working in there with Suminen. This is McClellan behind the Soviet goal. Still has it. Looks at that, but scores! Suminen waiting by the side of the net.
Smart plays, heavy plays, skillful plays by the Soviets. Watch this. McClellan just outfought them behind the net. They had everybody watching him, everybody on the ice except Suminen, who anticipated that the pass was going to come in front of the net. He moved in, and there you see him.
That's Anderson. Gretzky gets it up for Curry. Curry shot it just wide. And then backhanded the rebound out in front, claimed quickly by the Soviets, who start back. This is Makarov. Down the left side, Makarov. Pushed off the puck by Huddy. Soviets playing shorthanded. Krutov couldn't control it. Here's Copy with Gretzky at the line. Copy left it for Gretzky. He didn't think it was going that way. Krutov backhands it down. 41 seconds left in the Edmonton power play. Copy coughed it up. Soviets going in. Score! Bykov. Copy made the miscue. Bykov walked in 19.
Moog almost got a piece of it. But again, there's no way in the world you allow that back man to handle the puck and attempt to make a pass from that position. It wasn't a good pass on Coffey's stick. Coffey has to be behind the passer in that instance. And Bykov just went between the legs, found the five hole. It's a bad pass, but nevertheless, when you're making that type of a pass, whether you're a man short or five aside, folks, the pass receiver is behind you.
Well, the Soviets, Tiumenov with Makarov and Krutov, the forward front, their best line. Coffey, difficulty along the boards for the Oilers, finally gets it free for Suminen. Suminen had it taken away by Krutov. Now Coffey lost it out front. Moves the save out in front. The red light is on. Do they count it a goal or not? Another costly mistake for the Oilers in their own zone. The net is off its moorings. The light went on.
I've constantly, folks, been talking about the Soviets flooding the zone. And on this goal here, this is what they did out on the blue line. This is the start of it. That's a bad pass, really. And you don't make silly little passes like that in the middle of the rink. You take it bodily out of the trouble area, or you pass it into that corner.
McClellan working along the boards. It comes out to Coffey, who dumps it back in for McClellan. Fedosov can't hold it. McSorley back, cleared out in front. Good chance for the Oilers. But it was Suminen who couldn't quite tip it and gain control. Now Makarov starts back. Makarov, one man and a goalie to beat, drops it back. Krutov scores.
Oh.
That's how it's done.
You'll not see it any nicer than that, folks. Even coming out of their own end. I think it was Makarov finally put it in. But just watch this. He'll draw a player to him, cut to the middle. There's the drop pass. Now he'll go wide and lay it right across. Oh, just beautiful. And it was just a nice teed-up shot, an effortless shot. Coming out, there's the key. Here, it's a one-on-nobody. Okay, or one-on-one. Now it's a two-on-one. Now it's a three-on-two, and that third guy is just home free.
He's against probably as good a club team as there is in the world, so.
Chance for the Soviets here, going right in. They score! Veselov beats Andy Mode for the sixth time. And boy, they can score quickly.
Oh, they can.
They don't miss the golden opportunity.
All right, here's the pass. Look at it. Hits the stick, but the Veselov picks it up and takes one look there, one look, and he sees where Moog is, and Andy had to be coming out a little more. There wasn't very much room, but he picked it. He had a pretty good angle right here. There's the pass to the open man, and that's their key, to the skating man as well. He moved the puck from the toe of his stick onto the heel and let it go.
Piamenov, number 28, gets it over on the left side. At the Oiler line and across. Gusarov finally lost it. Kevin Lowe claimed it. This is Curry. He's got Gretzky out there. The pass just failed to materialize as far as the Oilers were concerned. Part of the story tonight, Howie. The Oiler passing game has just been off a little bit, hasn't it?
That's right. There's absolutely no doubt about that at all. I've not seen the Oilers handle a puck.
There's Gretzky out in front. Tried the backhand. Anderson picked up the rebound. 6-3. Gretzky, that patented move out in front. Anderson had the rebound and beat Malenkov.
Well, Malenkov comes, will make a great save here in Gretzky, but he's down again. And now look at Anderson. Anderson cuts the grass. He has one skate on the ice, does a pivot. Now Gretzky hangs on, comes out in front. There's the backhand, and Malenkov makes the save. Anderson outfought his check.
Time running out. 15 seconds to play. The shot, Moog, is bounced on his backside, but the shot didn't get through that time. Hunter goes to the far side. Napier gets across the line, feeds it through for McTavish, and he couldn't control it. That's going to be the old hockey game as the Edmonton Oilers go down to the feet in a hockey game where a few Oiler mistakes cost them dearly. Malenkov, Sergei Malenkov, has won twice in a row in North America. Over Los Angeles last night and over the defending Stanley Cup champions this evening, both by 3-goal margin.
Well, you saw the game played this evening, folks, as it should be played. A team with four lines and of skilled hockey players, and the same on defense, all skate extremely well, all handle the puck, and all very well disciplined. That's the key to me, how disciplined they were. They played on defense like they had to and on offense like they can.
Central Red Army coming up with a 6-3 victory over the Edmonton Oilers.